So now we'll be discussing a very specific aspect of chest x-ray, that is approach to a foreign body on a chest x-ray, whether it's ingested or aspirated. So when you're seeing a foreign body, which we've already talked about, that the density of the foreign body, particularly a metallic foreign body, would be much higher than that of the bones. So that is how you pick up a foreign body in the first place. Once you've picked it up, to localize it, whether the child, most commonly a child will be presenting with a foreign body. So whether the child has ingested it, that is, it is lying in the esophagus, or it's lying in the trachea, the child has aspirated it. So as you know, chest x-ray is a frontal projection. It's a 2D representation where the trachea and esophagus will be lying in the same plane. We're looking at it from a PA view. So on the frontal projection, there is no way to know if you have a centrally projected foreign body, whether it's lying in the esophagus or trachea. So the trick to find out is that the esophageal foreign body, that is an ingested foreign body, will be lying end face, as we are seeing in this particular image, that we are seeing the complete disc here, that is the foreign body is end face, suggestive of its esophageal location, suggesting that the child has ingested it. However, in the case of airway location of the foreign body, what we'll be seeing is a sagittal plane. So the foreign body will be lying in the sagittal plane, and the most common site of it being stuck would be the right main bronchus, as you can see. So while the esophagus has constrictions near the aortic arch, it will be here higher up where the normally location of the trachea is there, while a airway foreign body will be lying in this particular location where we have the right mainstem bronchus, because it has a vertical and a straighter course, allowing a foreign body to pass into it and getting lodged there. So these are the two important tricks. You look at the shape of the foreign body and you look at the location of the foreign body. And the easiest way is to do a lateral x-ray to confirm. So on the lateral x-ray, we have these two structures separated. So as we can see, this air-filled structure, darker structure, and the anterior structure is the airway, and the posterior structure here will be the esophagus. So if you have the foreign body located posterior to the air-filled airway, it is esophageal in location or ingested foreign body, whereas if it is lying in the airway or the blacker structure, that means the child has aspirated it.